Ensemble, and as you can see, we are a mix of people from different backgrounds, and the music also you will be perceiving that has this influence of different backgrounds, although mainly what we play is Latin American music. The first tune is called Tumbajito, and the title is after a Cuban war that it refers to the group played either by the conga player or the bass player, and the word is tumbao. And the idea for this original piece came while I was practicing my bass, and so the seed for this tune came while practicing the bass. So to honor the Cuban tradition and the bass that inspired this tune, I called it Tumbajito, which is a mix of bajo in Spain, in Spanish, which is the bass instrument, and as well the word for the Cuban group, tumbao. The next tune we're gonna play is Camila's Dance, is the title of the tune, and it's dedicated to my daughter. It has a Brazilian rhythm to it. Thank you. Acheray is a word that doesn't have any particular translation by itself, but it's a name that I came up with blending two different words. One is Ache, which comes from the Yoruba language from Africa, and it's very popular in the Afro-Cuban music, but rather it's part of the religious lexicon of the Yoruba culture and music. But in my case, the use of the word that I appreciate is the word, the daily language, because Cubans, they say to each other, Ache para ti, meaning good luck for you. I address the good energy in you and I honor that. That's Ache, that's the half of the name. There is another word that comes from northern Ecuador in the Andes, and it's from a different language, which is Quichua, and that word is Churay. And Churay in the Quichua language means put it on. And musicians say it to each other when they are playing together, and they feel that one of the musicians is really bringing up this beautiful energy and into the music. So the other musicians, they will address him by saying, Churay, Churay, put it on. And being these two sources of inspiration for the music in this ensemble, the Afro-Cuban, the Afro-Latin traditions, as well as the indigenous music from South America mainly. So I decided to put the two words together and cut it a little bit, a clip here, a clip there, and Acheray came as the name to the band to honor those two cultures.
I would like to say that it doesn't have to be just musicians, though. If you want to yell out, Chura!
Oh, yeah, anytime.
You feel anytime. So moved, you know. I know I want to do it every time Alberto does a solo back
there. Alberto from Havana, Cuba. So we're going to switch geographies here, and we're going to go to the northern part of South America, and we're going to play La Viquina, if we may. And that comes from Venezuela. It's a folk tune, one of the most famous tunes from Venezuela, La Viquina. Thank you. next one is another Venezuelan tune by Hugo Blanco, Venezuelan composer. Venezuela also has a Caribbean influence in the northern area of their country. And so this is a more upbeat tune. And it shares characteristics with music from Puerto Rico and other islands in the Caribbean region. So we are not going to play it in the original way. We are going to play it more with a mix of an influence from Cuba and Puerto Rico. What we are bringing in this arrangement, into this arrangement, is some Cuban rhythms, and in a section we are using bomba, which is a traditional rhythm from Puerto Rico, a folkloric rhythm from Puerto Rico. And the title of the tune is Moliendo Café, one of Greg's favorites.
Yes, it is. And because if it goes too fast, it becomes a Moliendo Espresso.
Moliendo Café. Moliendo Café is grinding.
It's trying to keep it at a cafe tempo. So.
Right. So for you, Moliendo Café, grinding coffee. Thank you.
guitar. And Greg Snedeker on cello.
We need a just 1 second to do some adjustments. How is the sound, by the way? Are we too loud? No? Okay, you are out here, so please let us know. We are going to play another Venezuelan tune, and we are going to use they always do that. There is the música llanera that it is shared by Colombia and Venezuela. We all know that. Borders are just imaginary lines. So, and Colombians are, and Venezuelans are a good example of that. They share a music culture in the eastern part of their countries and los llanos. And part of the music of that region is this instrument called cuatro, which has roots in a Portuguese instrument that was brought to the Americas. And it took a different form of guitar in Brazil, and they call it cavaquinho in Brazil, which is a similar one, it's not exact. But another one that is very popular here, and I don't need to introduce that one, which one would that be? That looks like this. The ukulele. Yeah, ukulele, Venezuelan cuatro, and the cavaquinho, they have the same roots in a small Portuguese guitar. So, we're gonna play this, it's called El Diablo Suelto, The Devil in the Loose. And it's from Venezuela, and I wanna honor Germán, a dear Colombian friend who is here tonight with his wife, and we're gonna dedicate it to him, okay? El Diablo Suelto. Thank you.
actually, this next one is from Brazil. It's a choro. And a choro is a sort of an offshoot of the samba. It means to cry. And this is a very famous choro by Zaquina Abreu, which is called Tico Tico no Fubá, which loosely translates to sparrow in the cornmeal. I didn't name it.
Yourself or together?
Let's do it together.
we're going to continue, and there is a region in South America, in the Atlantic coast of South America, that is called El Río de la Plata, and it's a region that is shared by Uruguay and Argentina. On one side is the region of the capital of Argentina, Buenos Aires, and the other side is Uruguay. And music-wise, they have an influence, an African influence there, that is present in the tango genre, in the milonga form of the tango genre. Some of you might be familiar with milonga or with tango, and milonga is the upbeat version of tango music. On the other side of the Rio de la Plata, of the river, is Uruguay, and there is a large Uruguayan, Afro-Uruguayan community there. They have their own traditional music, and their rhythm is called candombe. The most representative rhythm from Uruguay, from the Afro-Uruguayans, is candombe. We're gonna play a song that it's not a Latin American song. It's a jazz standard by Joe Henderson, and it's called Recordame. So what we did is we brought the song down to the El Rio de la Plata, down there, and kind of introduced Joe Henderson to that area, so South America, so Recordame. Thank you.
Solo guitar piece. Loro wrote dozens of these beautiful Venezuelan waltzes for guitar solo. And this is one that Juan Carlos and I have been playing together for, this is one of the first things we played together when we first started playing. So it's Andreina, which is named after, I believe it's one of Loro's nieces. I think just about every piece he wrote is named after one of his nieces. So I think he has about 30 nieces. I don't know. But originally, it was a beautiful little guitar piece, and this arrangement has sort of expanded on a lot of the things that, Laura was doing. You enjoy it?
Thank you.
Thank you. So, continuing around South America, we are going to play a piece, an original piece. It was inspired and inspired by the music of Mongo Santa Maria, a Cuban conga player. One of his famous pieces and known in the United States is called Afro Blue, and it was popularized by John Coltrane. This somehow makes a reference to that great piece, and it's called Mongo Blues, and it's written in an Afro-Peruvian style, which is called Festejo.
Thank you.
another tune that it's not a Latin American tune, but it's going to sound like if it would be one. Beautiful Love, and it's a jazz standard, but we're going to play it as a Cuban bolero.
Long live Cuba!
Thank you.
we're going to play next an Andean tune from this. It's the region of Bolivia, Peru, and northern Argentina. They play this rhythm called samba. And although it's pronounced as the Brazilian samba, but they are two different styles. And so this is from the northern region of Argentina, and we are going to use the charango, which is another small guitar from the Andean culture. The name of the tune is Quespinha.
Juan Carlos Carpio on the charango bass.
Next tune doesn't need an introduction. It's very famous, one by Chicoria. Still, we are staying in the Latin American environment. And we are going to play Spain with a little bit of flavor from Dominican Republic. There is a folkloric rhythm there that it's called pandiche. I'm not going to tell you the story this time about this rhythm. But it's sent to the American soldiers and the American base in the Dominican Republic. This rhythm was created so that they could dance. So the Dominicans said, oh, let's adapt it something here so that they can dance to this rhythm. So kind of they moved some things around and their music, and the result was a new style that they called pandiche.
Probably wondering what this is, huh? Anyone know what this is? Oh, go on, shout it out if you know it. It's actually called a melodica. It's because I'm aspiring to be an accordionist, but I can't quite get there, so it sounds a lot like an accordion.
The small German accordion was introduced in the early 20th century to Dominican Republic, and it's currently part of this folkloric music style. So thanks to Greg that he has many tricks under his. He's gonna play that and somehow bring that spirit of the accordion in there.
Feel free to yell at Shirai when I play this. That's the only time I'm playing it. So. Thank you.
And cello. Jeremy Milligan. Jeremy Milligan on guitar. Carl Clements on wind instruments. Putting everything together, Hidalberto Perdomo from Cuba. I just want to say a couple of things before we go. Is I want to thank to Paul Newling for having us, and Charles Mann for making that great contact. Thank you. You made it possible for us to and for to connect with Paul. Okay. And ultimately, to these great musicians, I've been having this vision of putting this music together. But a lot of things have me to put this project on hold. But now here we are, so with the help of these wonderful musicians, they brought the music to life. Thank you. We're going to play a tune from Cuba, if I can find it. Okay, good. This is by the great Chucho Valdez. He's one of the greatest Cuban piano players, jazz piano players, not exclusively jazz. And this one of his famous tunes is called Mambo Influencial. Thank you once again for coming and sharing the music with us.
Thank you.